somebody want to ask a Dharma, Jampa want to ask somebody.
Why this business? I mean, born, die. What are we trying to achieve?
We are not trying to achieve individually anything. We are here because every plant, every animal, every creature, every Buddha, everyone has got some service to do with the other. No, I may not be requiring, but somebody else require some Buddha is required for some other Buddha. As human being, if I am there or not, nothing. Everybody is thinking that I am indispensable. No, everybody is indispensable. Nothing is going to change. But having taken birth, what is to be done is what we can think. Otherwise, it becomes too much of a philosophy. Every plant, every animal, every Buddhatma has got some purpose for its life. What are we trying to invent? Having taken birth, which is not of my choice. I have not chosen my life. I got my life. It may be somebody's kridanartham, good karma or bad karma, I don't know. But I have given a birth. Now what is to be done? Let me think seriously what best I can do. Until my last breath, I am supposed to think what I can do to do good things. We don't do many things. It is not killing somebody, even scolding somebody, even getting angry to somebody, even annoying somebody. All these are bad karma. But you don't have to worry about it. That's what it says. Because you are not scolding the atma of the other person. With this sharira, you are becoming unproductive. So probably you will have to give him an advice. So how do we make this life better and life for somebody's purpose? Having taken birth, now what is to be done? That only we have a right to ask. Otherwise, we are not here. I am not here. You are not here to ask also. Understood? So, having taken birth, we are eligible to ask this question. So, what is to be asked? Why should we take birth? No option. Because we have already taken birth. So, what is to be done? Let me think what I can do good for others. Ena kena prakarena yasya kasyabi dehinaha sandosham janayat pratna tadevam ishvara pujam. Do that puja service to people in some way, somehow, somewhere, somebody. Get some benefit which I can do, then my life becomes worthy. In that process, probably you need to do some harm to somebody else also. That is justifiable. You don't have to be worried. That is what Bhagavad Gita teaches us. What is the purpose of this sloka? You don't have to worry about small perturbation. Some small disturbance, some karma which you do. Because people all thought that, you know, Ashtanga Yoga, which has got different steps in which, first thing is non-violent. But then you cannot live in this world becoming non-violent because you need to put something set in right. You have to use that force. If you don't use it, things will not be in straight order. So keep it in order. You need to be potentially active. That is what the message is. That is what Bhagavan says. Otherwise, Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara. Yama is non-violent. That is why many people ask Bhagavad Gita is against Yoga Shastra. Non-violent to whom? It is not non-violent at all. Because non-violent to the Atma. You are not being non-violent to the Atma. Because of your satsang, you are not understanding what is bad. Therefore, you think everybody does good. It is not that everybody does good. There are now further chapters will tell you why somebody is not good. Because their samskara. What is their samskara? They have got different gunas. Based on the guna, they may become slightly bad. So you need to teach them the lesson. Atma is not bad. But in this sharira, it has gone slightly bad. So what is to be done? It's like we have taken birth, but when there is a body part of us which is unmaintainable, what do we do? Doctor, cut it off. So similarly, in this Atma, which is residing in a body, the whole body is dangerous. What you should do? Cut it off. That is what Bhagavan says.
to come to this stage and coming and attending your Zoom meeting, trying to understand Bhagavad Gita, I took a lot of pain. Studied, took a birth, undergone all the pain and pleasures, educated, worked, earned, service, all these things. So how long do I need to take this? Again and again.
You don't have to think about it. That is what the whole purpose of life is, when you do it devotionally. Is it that Dr. TPS wanted to teach Bhagavad Gita? I taught, never. Somebody asked me, you have to teach. Anu asked me, you should teach this. So I did it. So somebody demands it, you are doing it. Because somebody feels, so with this life, this is what is that I want you to do. So that some more people. So it like comes as a message. We are all part of that orchestra which is already planned by somebody. We are playing roles of ours. But sometimes we don't understand that it needs to come into that satsang to understand it. Otherwise, we may miss this. Not necessarily we will not miss it in our lifetime like this also. Maybe after some time I may miss it also. That's what Bhagavan will tell in the later chapters. Even if you miss in between, again you can restart from where you stopped in the next Janma. You don't have to start from the beginning. So everything is like an account which you have got your life, which is becoming credited. You may have a dead account for some time because you are not getting that revenue. Doesn't matter. The credit will carry on. And sometime my relationship with Dharma will allow me to take an overdraft from your account also to me. That is what is satsanga. That is what the guru and the shishya parampara. I am not what I am because what I studied in my previous janma at all, probably. But I happen to meet a guru who has given everything what he has on to my head. That is what my guru did, Brahmasri KPC. When I met him, he kept his hand and then told him that everything what I learned is giving to you in my life. Everything is given to you. That Ashirvada is what is given. Whether I have taken it or not, you know, it did not mature that enough that time. So it took another 6 more years to understand what he gave to me. Do you think that these lokas I learned in my life? I never heard lectures in anybody's life. I never sat in somebody's satsang. I never learned. It's only Swadhyaya. I have got a Chinmaya book. I have got a Nitya Chaitanya Edi book. But understanding the concept is not what is taught in philosophy lecture in some class. Once you get it, this is what is the... That karma what probably he has done, what he said in my previous janma, in this janma, whatever rituals I did, with all that I am giving to you. That blessing if you have, probably you will reach, maybe you are a little faster, that's it. But you have to make it to grow. Somebody has given not the seed, somebody has given a plant inside your garden. But if you don't protect it and water it, it will die. It can only make it to grow faster. You need to put more effort to make it to grow better. We are all part of it. That is what says Bhagavad Gita, learning, chanting, any of these scriptures, having this satsang itself is one of the biggest blessing. Otherwise, where do we meet? Myself and Dilip ji met only a few months back. But as we met, there was a connection. And that connection is our gurus were connected. So that connection makes it bondage. Otherwise, we don't meet. You have seen when we were having Bhagavad Gita satsang, some foreigner, the local person came and gifted Bhagavad Gita to us, right? Which I was just asking, where is Gita plus Bhagavad Gita I would have had? From where he comes? These are all some blessings which comes at.
Yeah, I remember. Yep. Thank you.
Excuse me, sir. Sir, Bhagavad Gita tells that do not be sad. We'll be sad when we do bad. So why does the God does not end this bad, sir?
So don't do bad. Don't do bad.
No, sir, I'm asking why does the God does not end the bad?
He is not asking to do bad. There is nothing bad. Bad and good is where, when, why, how. In front of him, for whom you are doing.
There is no good, there is no bad.
There is no good and bad. It's only time will determine what is good, what is bad. It will only tell in front of whom you are doing. That makes it good or bad. for whom you are doing, that can make it good or bad. Everything is relative.
Yeah. On the comedy side, this is just a joke. Al Qaeda leader Bin Laden and the guys who are in Afghanistan now, lucky that they didn't read the Bhagavad Gita.
There are many people who did not read Bhagavad Gita.
Otherwise, they will go and kill everyone and say, sir, you know, I'm killing based on situation.
No, but your interpretation is not for the specific small set of people. It has to be for the Loka Dharma. What is acceptable to the Logam is what is called Dharma, not for me. There is an individual Dharma, for me everything looks Dharma. But my Dharma is not acceptable to my family, it cannot be Kudumba Dharma.
Okay.
My Kudumba Dharma, when it is not acceptable to the society, it cannot be Kudumba Dharma is fine. I am a butcher, but I wanted to start a meat shop here, but my neighbors don't accept it. Then I am doing adharma. I have to take care of my neighborhood, my society, my district, then my rashtra, then loka. So my dharma keeps on increasing from individual to as a unit, as a society, as a group. What I have done is perfect for Al Qaeda. But LTTF also done. Everybody can claim we are good. But is that good for a bigger cause for a longer run? That need to be understood by a bigger society. That's why dharma is not a small iota. Dharma is the universe. Loka dharma, that is important. So how far I fit into loka dharma is what is to be asked, answered.
Nilaya, I like to ask.
Yeah. Namaskar, Nilaya.
Unmute yourself.
Unmuted.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much, and namaste. Thank you to all for this wonderful sharing of this very vast knowledge. What came to my mind is like, because it feels to me Bhagavad Gita as a rose, and when you can grab the rose by the thorn and then you hurt yourself. But then if you look at the rose and you understand the rose, you can understand the place to touch. And if you touch hard on the petals, they won't be nice. You have to wait also, like if the rose is like this, you have to wait the moment it becomes a rose. And then, again, you have to understand that it has a time and it won't be like that forever. But we are humans. As human beings, we received from the universe, like we make a communion with the creation of the universe. And then we can create, we can make the rose live forever as a poem, as a photograph, as an art. So when I listen, I was listening to the professor and he was talking about the Sloka 18. And Shakespeare came to my mind because there's this wonderful sonnet 18 who felt for me a very important intertwining connection. So I think we as human beings, those type of knowledge, they are not fixed. The words are not like this, like sharp. The words are like the water. The words are like flow. So it is very important to learn to read, not to get fixed. It's okay?
Yes. Life is, we bloom, we mature, and we die. But within that time, as human, We have a great potential to do many things. Being that activating is what is the essence of Bhagavad Gita. How much productive you can, how much helpful you can, with that spur of a time, maybe a small time which we have, where you can contribute for the goodness of many people around. That is what the rose is also doing. The rose, as it blooms, it may not have the smell. As it dies, it doesn't have the smell. But between that life, it is giving it fragrance around. But there may be thousands of roses where no, maybe flies or bees would have come. But not a human would have gone and then plucked it or then smelled it. Maybe there may be some flower where nobody even looked at it. But still, it took its life and then went. So this taking life and going out is part of our life. How much you can become helpful, that becomes more spiritual. So our purpose of life becomes when we serve others. Even as a flower, when it is being served, when it is bloomed, it is supposed to serve somebody. It is the aspiration of a flower. That is why it gave a different color by Bhagavan. See, the green leaves around which the red flower is given. You will never see a green flower by nature. Night when it is blossomed, it gives white color. So that in midnight, the white color can be seen. So the purpose of every creation is how I can be helpful for somebody else. Any Buddha. Buddha means any creature, any living being in the world. If I am of some help, my life is perfect. Purpose is served. That is what Bhagavad Gita teaches all of us.
That if I can a little bit longer, because I wish to share, since I started with the class of Bhagavad Gita, my life became the Mahabharata. So I felt myself really having to leave the Pandavas, the fight with my brothers because of a situation. But suddenly, as I was practicing and trying to, because I was talking to people, I've learned yoga from Swami. I am a Swami representative. What am I doing? I was so upset and because I was in fight. And then suddenly it came to my mind that whatever we do in this planet, we are sharing something. So I decided I needed to share beauty and joy. So I went to see a woman to help me get my nails polished and to be beautiful. So after that, I understood I needed to forgive my brothers because they were doing those fight against me because they were upset. They had a deep pain that they were not knowing how to deal with that. So they were putting out that anger, that violence, because they were asking for help. So then I decided to pray for him, for them, for the both of them. And then as I decided to make a prayer for them, then all my friends, because now I have a lot of, how do you call this? Well, I don't have the funds I used to have when my mom was down here. Now she's throwing rays from heaven to see if I open my mind and start listening. And then I have all my life taken care of. Like one friend called me to breakfast, the other one called me for lunch, the other called me for dinner. I have a place to stay. I have an office so I can have the class. So I feel so grateful for this. Thank you so, so much.
Glad we are in conversation.
Sir, Arjuna's grandfather, their Guruji, they're all support, they are good sir. Good means they support the dharma. So why they are Kaurava side, sir? Why they can't be with Pandava, sir? Why they are not Pandava side? They are with Kaurava side.
There are many reasons because they have taken an oath that they will support them. So sometime that individual dharma was kept stronger, but the main cause was not considered. So they were slightly wrong in that sense. Yeah, Anu.
So whatever Arjuna had done, so was it because of his previous karma, or is was it because of his dharma that he has to do all this, like fight against his own people and all that?
It is.
So is karma or dharma more responsible for whatever he had done?
See, whatever karma is being done, it will add on to the dharmic values of the person. So, action is only temporary. Your dharma balance is like every month you are getting salary for the every job which you do. The job keeps on changing. But what remains is your dharma. That dhanam which get contributed, accounted in your bank is your dharma part. Action keeps on doing. So every one of us have got an account which is like a dharma account. When I do something wrong, it's like overdue, and therefore there was a shortcut, then deduction happens from there. If I keep on adding my values, every action only can contribute to my dharma. Like every action only can contribute to my credit in the bank. That's what it is. So it's both. I can do more karma when my dharma value is more. Otherwise, I will not be able to reach into this community. This satsang is because of my credit. And what has happened? My guru has come and deposited a lot of things on me. He says, take this credit also into your credit. Correct? So when we meet a lot of people, that keeps on coming. Anu comes and says, take my credit also to you. Dharma comes and says, take this credit also. And who will get this credit? Overdrafting. When I am in relation with Dilip ji, immediately somebody will say, oh, you have a good contact? Yes. So I can take his reference. So immediately I will connect him and then talk to somebody who is in Hyderabad. Yes, the other day when we met, immediately I spoke to that Hyderabad person. What is my credit? It is not my credit. He referred me there. That is what the reference system which we have in bank. Everybody has got a love account, everybody has got a spirituality account. Atmiyata is a big account in which we keep on putting. But the beauty of this account is, unlike your financial account, you can transfer from one janma to another janma. The financial account, once it is over, you have to divide and give it to your children or whoever you are authenticating to get it. But your this Atmiya Dharma, or maybe the spiritual value, the Savidya part, you cannot authorize somebody to take it. You have to find somebody where you can transfer it with Ashirvada, with Satsang, with a lot of mutual understanding each other. Lot of that is essential. Otherwise, why Meenakshi I never met? Only through Satsang we met. When there is a small correction, I say, no, what is the authority which we have? That's the authority which we take overdue. We take account overdue. This is being done. This is part of it. Jayanti Sahu I never met. But I don't think a day is there in her life these days where she don't think about me. Correct? Because she knows I am going to scold her tomorrow. So she is waiting for that day. Correct?
Sir, who is Bhishma Pitamaha, sir? Why did he sleep on...
Google. You have to Google and then ask. Don't ask Google questions to me. Google is a better Acharya than me. I am a small Acharya. Google is a big Acharya. So whenever big questions comes, don't ask Dr. Tiplis. You should ask Google. Hey Google Bhagavan. Then Google Bhagavan will give you answer. No general knowledge questions to me.
So in the earlier sloka you mentioned that whenever a dress becomes untidy, like you change and continue. So in the same way, whenever the body becomes unmanageable, it's like a dress, you throw it out and you continue, your atma continues with the new body. But then, so when a dress becomes untidy and when you change, you are the same person. You have everything, like same consciousness and everything. But when atma goes into a new body, but that atma does not have the previous consciousness, or it doesn't remember anything from the previous body. So why does that happen? So
the simile is taken in poetry not to depict the whole thing. It is only to understand the concept. Even this atma, when it goes into a small child, it doesn't have all that value system as this person was dying. That's 100% understood. But only thing, when he is put into a beautiful groove with a beautiful environment, that absorption of the ideas becomes much more faster or easier for him. It doesn't mean he will have the whole knowledge. It needs a reminder. That is because this atma is not what is eternal, which is inside me, which makes me to have satsang, which is not giving me the whole energy. I have got different spare parts in which one portion is only atma. I have got buddhi, I have got my manas, I have got my body, which exists in an environment. All that together has got some contribution. Atma is some part of it. When everything fits well, probably it will rise. Otherwise, it may not even rise. It may not even show. Therefore, you will have to wait for another janma. So, not necessarily even the growth will give me that portion. All the testing is also being done. Whether it is accepting, whether it is growing, whether it is... all that is part of our... like a nature being tested, no? This will keep on going for one janma, next janma, next janma. It may also vanish sometime. That's why I say, if I don't take the credit, it's like a different business. With my credit, I started a business. Does it mean with this credit, it will grow all the time? It may also lose. So in the next janma, this Satyuga credit, the Savidya credit may come down because I did not use it.
That means, like, for example, if you are an Atmiya Purusha in your earlier birth, say you have been a very good person, enlightened person and all that, in your next birth, you can become a devil of a person?
Possible. In this Janma itself, there are people, they kept on talking about Atmiya Purusha, Atmiya Charitra, Bhagavad Gita, Saptaham and all that. When he became old, he felt that these are all useless. And he started becoming reverse also. There are a lot of people, it is not that Atmiyada doesn't mean you know Bhagavad Gita, therefore you are a spiritual man. Just because you did some Bhagavad Gita reading or you know a lot of philosophy, that doesn't mean you are a spiritual person. This is only like a measurement. Engineer knows how to measure it and then do it. Otherwise also people constructed houses without even knowing the measurement and patterns, right? It was much beautiful house. Do you think every bird is learning how to make a nest in the BTEC course in civil engineering? So, the ability of doing something, knowing something is not at all part of the human nature. That nature gives us a spirituality which is unmeasurable. So, in my life made simple, I've got a small note which says spirituality can never be measured. But there are people who says, I'm a spiritual guru. People only should look at them and laugh. What this stupid fellow is saying? How much spirituality we have? See, I only said some portion of that got into me, which is my ego. Whether it is there in me or not, I cannot even measure. How much is there, we cannot measure. How much is that 100%, we cannot measure. Now, just now you said, I told. I did not tell. I was only interpreting what Bhagavan said. Whether that interpretation itself is correct or not, we should ask him only. Somebody else will say, oh, this is wrong. Who says this is wrong? See, when many people are chanting, I am circulating. To some people, I don't even send. There are good friends of mine. They will find a lot of mistakes in that. Intentionally, I am not even telling them that is being given. It is not that I cannot find mistakes. Even my chanting, there can be mistakes. What is overall good in that is what he should accept. What is good in that is what we have to communicate. Whether we can do that much better and better and better, like Nilaya said, there are wrong and good. Some potential time, impotential action happened. That can be wrong. But tomorrow you identify and correct it, that is the best blessing which you have. If you can do that, you are progressing. If you are not doing it, you are going down. That's it. Not in my concept, not in Bhagavan's concept, in my satsang concept. People who are around me consider so.
Srigala like to ask. Srigala Sunil.
Srigala Sunil Nambiar.
We were talking about the soul.
Yeah.
Like the Atma is the soul.
Yes.
So I also have read in some studies about spirituality. It's something like we think we have already the soul, but if we take the analogy you brought about the house, we live, we are born, we live with this body, with this spirit, mind, Atma, but do we really understand what it is? Do we really have it? Do we really taste it? So it feels like we live in a house that is gorgeous, filled with many rooms, but we just stay in a very small place and we don't go anywhere else. But it's like we dream, we think we have the whole house, but we are only in a small room. So, I have a difficulty on, sometimes I'm connecting with people because it feels for me that mind, it's very, very rigid. So what would be the part on the Bhagavad Gita that brings it forth about the real nature of this flowing mind? How do we...
Understood. Now I am in a room. I am in a room inside my house. What is my house? Is the floor is my house, or the roof is my house, or the window is my house, or the door is my house, or the wall is my house, or the cupboard is my house? I am not staying anywhere. I am staying inside the air where all these are not there. So where am I staying inside my house? In the air. Is the same air here is outside my house also? So if I jump out of my wall and go into my nature, is there any difference? Only thing, there is a wall. There, the wall is not there, I am out of the wall. If you understand that, that is what Atma should realize. I must go out of this body and free myself. So when I come to your place, Nilaya's house is my house. Because that nature is where here, the same nature is there. When I go to New York, it is Dilipji's house is also my house. Because there is no difference. When we get compartmentalized and saying, this is my body, this is my house, Atma cannot understand everything. Once you free from this and then get out, everything remains one. Everything remains same. That is what we need. That openness. Absorb everything. accept everything. There is no me. That's why he said, your level becomes very low level if I think this is my body. I am permanent here. This is my house. This is my body. Instead of that, the whole world is my house. I am not this body. I am outside this body. I am that Atma. I am that soul which is there in everyone. If that concept comes, I become a universal entity. Being that universal entity with the nature is what is Sukham for me. I was in Delhi. Delhi is the capital city of India. I did not have a house. When I got transferred, I wrote to all my friends, those time Orkut. I want a house. 47 people offered their house to me. If I had a house, I will never ask. So having a house is a disadvantage. Because I didn't have a house, I am sure today if I do it, many more will come. If I don't have a house, I have got more houses. So sometime you feeling you have, you are becoming more and more and more poor in this world. When I go abroad in different places, there are a lot of people come and stay for one day with me. That invitation comes and then I can, when I have a house in my native, I cannot stay in somebody's house. Even to my own brother's house, I will not go and stay because I have my own house. So it's better be part of the universe than being selfish. Beautiful concept.
Like when I visit India, I go to my house, put my suitcase, evening I leave the house. After 1.5 months, I come back to my house, take my suitcase and come back to me. That 1.5 months I am staying with the people and different ashrams and events. You know? So in the nutshell, we all are made of 5 elements. We are in the universe, living in the universe, the universe also made of 5 elements. That means we are the universe, right? When we have the nature, Atma, related to the other Atmas, we are one. But there is no mind. Our house, right? So entire universe is our house. When we have this concept, there is no point of having a conflict. This is the problem you see around the globe. People fight for land which is not belong to us. We are a tenant. Instead of we are thinking we are a tenant, I belong to this. This is from my family or from my religion. See what is going on in Afghanistan or any other place. So we have to update ourselves.
Today, being the Karma Yajurveda day, I will teach biggest yatna which everyone could practice, so simple. Agnihotra yatna. In Agnihotra yatna, what we do, we take little bit of rice and ghee and give it to fire.
Yes, sir.
What is that we chant? Agnaye swaha. Agni, please eat this. I am not giving it because it's mine. Agnaye idam namama. This is given not by me. It is given by Agni only. Because of sun only, we have got wheat here, rice here, all the plants are growing. Every animal is growing because of sun. So I am giving to sun, which is represented by Agni, as a thanksgiving. Whose property? Don't think it is my property. Rice is not mine, ghee is not mine. It is Agni's only. Agnaye swaha, agnaye idam namama. Next sloka. Where did I get rice? Did I plant rice and then got it? No. Did I get ghee from the shop? Yes. Where did I get money? Because I work. Who gave me job? Somebody else money. Where did the ghee came from? The milk. Who gave the milk? Somebody else. Take care of that cow, somebody else. Who fed it? Somebody else. So how many people we are dependent on in this world? We are dependent on all people around us. Therefore, any benefit of this yatna, to whom it should go? Prajapataye swaha. Let it go to people. So why am I doing yatna, yaga, fire sacrifice in my house with a small basket? I am putting something and what am I chanting? Let the benefit go to everybody in the world. What a great concept is this. Suryaya swaha, suryaya idam namama, prajapataye swaha. It's all given by Prajapati. Whole people around me. Prajapataye idam namama. It belongs to them. It is not mine. Nothing is mine, nothing is mine, nothing is mine. Sacrifice is to teach you, it is not mine, it is not mine, it is not mine, it is somebody's. If you can understand that, whatever action I am doing, I am not attached to that, I am not bounded to that, I don't want any benefit out of it, it is somebody's. I am the last person to take credit for anything. Everything is somebody's. That's why I keep on saying, my knowledge is not mine, somebody's. I could also say, no, it's not mine. So it's all somebody's. I am only being a custodian, trustee. We are only trustees. Keep it, hand over to somebody else. That's it. So with that thought process, if you start dealing with people, you will enjoy. It's not mine.
It's like when we play on a theatrical play, there is a moment for one actor to speak, and then there shall be the other moment to the other one to speak. But who writes the play? It's the author. It's the divine.
Yeah.
We don't know the holes. We are always improvising. That feels for me like what you say. It's very like compassion. When we understand this limit that we set, but we don't know, like, I don't know why I was born in a family that offered me a lot, and I see people like Buddha. Buddha saw the man who had nothing and would live eating stones. But then he wanted to understand what it was that he didn't. He was still Buddha. There was still his family. There was his son, the castles, everything that was there. He still kept it. But then he developed, he opened himself to develop a compassionate way of teaching so that people might have a chance to, like you say, to be in somebody else's house. And then, like, if you don't have your house, but you are open to the universe become your house. So you have many, 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 many houses. But there is something for you to do with this. Maybe the way you have to be is going to college, become a doctor, bring in some beautiful knowledge to other people, and live it every day. What it is there for you to live. Maybe it is to earn money, and what shall I do with the money that I earn? Some people, they have this. They, like, they touch and money comes. I just know to do one thing. I just know to put money out. You can give money to me, it won't stay in my hand. And that's my talent.
No, you need for your maintenance. You need money to help others. You have more potential to work. You have to earn so that you can support people. That's all part of our job. We have got two roles. One as a social being, one as a human being. So we not just becoming human is impossible unless you have a societal commitment. So everyone cannot. We need to have that ability to support somebody else. So we have a different role. But when you become a politician, when you become a professor, when you become a teacher, when you become a doctor, don't be a doctor. Take the role of a doctor for some time, then come out of it to be a human. That is essential. So we have two roles. One, a professional body, and we have a human body. Some people always act that they are a professor. That's a problem. Some people think always they are a policeman. You should not. You have a different role. So we keep on going role. So I have got three principle balancing is life, which I say: role, goal, values. If you know how to balance this role, goal, value, harmony will come. That harmony is essential.
So, I have to go now. I have to excuse myself. And it was wonderful.
Enjoy.
You opened up my mind. Thank you so much.
Enjoy.
I hope, maybe next Sunday I have to excuse myself with you because I might need to see a friend. But I'll be back, okay?
Enjoy.
Thank you so, so much. Thank you all. Okay. Bye, Guruji. I hope I can go back to New York.
Yes.
I miss you all. Bye,
Brenda.
Bye, everyone.
So, another question from Srigala wrote, Guruji, on one side you have the Dharma and you want to fulfill, but on the other side you are challenged to fulfill it due to various influences. What should we do in such situation? You mentioned that every individual has certain gunas, though the soul is pure. What should be our thought to face such challenges?
That is what just now I answered. Without reading that question, the answer was given. Role, goal, value. So we have a role to play. Sometimes we will not be able to play our goal, which you think is a spiritual life. Probably you want to fit the values in position, but your role is not allowing. We have got, every one of us have got this constrained life. We are not like a free bird in this world. There are a lot of tie-ups. Everything is a tie-up. Profession is a tie-up. You need great courage. I was working in government. 20 years I decided good enough. My salary would have come 1/5 of my salary. My pension is only that much. All that position which we have, all that we have to leave. So sometime your goal, which you think is must, your role has to be redefined. But that role redefinition will not be accepted to everyone. Is it that Buddha was totally free? He left. Was it Shankara got full freedom? Mother told go. No, she did not allow. But she said, I will come back for my role when I am really required. You give me a sabbatical leave. So he left. So every one of us have got freedom. But how much is that the degree of freedom? That matters. And how much courage you have. That's why I keep saying, if you need Vivekananda, maybe a lot of people whom we are seeing as great personals in this world, all of them, imagine Aurobindo and all had done wonderful things in his life. He was in jail, he was caught, he showed that he can prove himself as a good administrator. He got educated in King's College London and became a IAS, Indian Administrative Service. If his father and mother would have been a normal school teacher and a school couple, do you think their parents will allow him to resign the job and get into politics? Mahatma Gandhi was a good lawyer. He would have earned and then stayed and then got a good name as a lawyer. He left everything. So there are people who had that courage. There are people who don't have that courage. That's all your degree of freedom. In mathematics, we have got a word called a degree of freedom. If you have good degree of freedom, probably your parametric can do more influence. Degree of freedom is less, your parametric influence on the function will become less. All of us have got role, goal, value. Balancing is life. Harmony, no harmony, disharmony, everything is because of these problems. Probably we will have to wait. I remember when boy came to my house for a camp from Abu Dhabi. We have a beautiful drama in which we will make their inner vision what to become to come out. So immediately one boy said, I am waiting for my mother to die to start a bar in New Zealand. His father and mother want him to be an engineer. So what he will do? He will complete. He is a brilliant student. So he will join IIT. He will pass BTech. He will get an MNC company and he will earn a lot of money. And he will wait until his parents die so that he can do what he wants in his life. So sometimes your role as a son stops you from doing what you want in your life. You will have to wait, expand. Probably you get a chance, you may not get a chance. That's a different matter. So there are different parameters which are constraints to us. There are different parameters which defines our degree of freedom. That needs to be balanced.
There's another question from J.N.D. Shahpur. Sir, could you please explain attachment and detachment with reference to dharma? How do you define swadharma? Who decides my swadharma?
What is good for you is your swadharma. But I want to listen to music. I enjoy music. So giving music and maybe dancing is my enjoyment. But then I should not do it in an apartment where I am staying in the first floor and my dancing disturbs the ground floor fellow. I am playing a music, I like jazz music. But then my family member doesn't like jazz music. That is why headphone is given. I must use it to listen so that I don't disturb somebody else. My dharma confined to me as an individual is my swadharma, which will not disturb, which will not question, which will not enter into their territory. That there can be family, profession, my kulam, my religion, my strict orders could be there, in which place I am staying. All that I must be able to understand. That is what my role. My role is a big word. My role in me, my role in my family, my role in my profession. I am a lawyer. My role in a court is how to lie so that my client gets benefit. But I should not become a lawyer in my house and then come all the false statements. I am a police. But that policing is within the territory of my police station. Outside my police station, when I am traveling in a train, don't behave like a police. I am not a police there. I am only a passenger. So if you understand that role well defined in where, when, the role is defined in different places. Where, when, why, how, that's what I am saying. Every action is a role. Good enough, Dilip ji?
Yeah. So next week we have a regular satsang. In September 14, we have a World Peace Festival, that is our 32nd annual program. We may have a few days, not sure. I know 14th definitely. And October 4th will be Guru Festival, our third annual celebration. We may have a continuous program with the Global Hindu Conference. We are talking about it. So once it's ready, we'll inform you. But anything else to announce?
That's it.
That's it.
We have now, I have a role of one university, international university, in which we have started a program on Bhagavad Gita, with Bhagavad Gita for happiness, Bhagavad Gita for different activities, as different certificate programs. There are some numbers, some emails. We can not decide it when the real program will start, it's only an announcement of beginning. We need a lot of people who can think of such programs which can be made into small certificates, so that we can, we started a spiritual wisdom center sort of a thing, where we can have a lot of such certificate programs. So under that spiritual wisdom, we can have free courses. It's all free courses, certificate programs, so that the university will take around the world. International Internship University. The idea is, people who are working, they wanted to learn. How do you make a certification program which will have probably like Nilaya? We have a lot of people across the globe who may be interested. Right. So these are all some initiatives. You could also have dialogues, understand. Don't have to wait for the satsang. Between that also, we keep dialoguing, myself and Dilipji. Many times we call and then talk what can be done. You could also have such discussions so that we can improve. And nice that many people are chanting and sending. This is an opportunity for all of us to learn. I'm also learning. Maybe brushing up little more, better and better. All of us can do this trial of chanting and sending it, so that at the end of the day we feel we have done some learning. Those who have not learned, those who have learned, it becomes a refreshing themselves. So I encourage only. I am putting them together and then posting it. When I post it, at least share and write some comments there, so that it becomes an encouragement. Yeah, Dilip ji.
Yeah, this Wednesday we have a interfaith prayer service for Afghanistan.
Oh.
We know we cannot do that much, go to that country and do things, but at least we can do a positive thoughts and pray for them. And there's a lot of suffering going on, especially women and children. And some dogmatic people, even there was a meeting happened last Friday, so a lot of people from that area and the religious group, a lot of time we cannot say a particular religion is bringing fighting around the globe. So we have to upgrade and update where people are doing around the globe. So I suggest to them, bring the humanitarian work more than religious work. So let us see how they are going to think. So thank you everyone. Thank you Dr. T.P. Sashimarji for your wisdom and teaching. We all enjoy.